YouTube. What's up? It's your boy, Prolific G Money, bringing you a Madden 20 tip. It's a very effective tip. It's been a very effective tip for the longest time, honestly. Let go of that turbo button, man. That's the tip. Let go of that turbo button. Let your blocks develop, and because if you ever notice and pay attention to the offensive line, that they don't hold their blocks. As soon as you hit turbo, for whatever reason, your offensive line lets go of their blocks or their assignment blocking assignment, and they're on to the next level. And that's how they're always in the backfield when you're trying to run the ball. But so I'm running with the New York Giants, Saquon Barkley. And the defense I'm playing against is the Dallas Cowboys. So here we go. So this is the first clip I have of what holding the turbo button does. As you can see, offensive linemen just get blown up by the defenders. They let go of their blocks. Everyone, 74 is getting beat right off the jump. He whiffs his block and you're in no man's land. So you try to make a move, but then you see the linebacker coming through. Maybe I could have cut it back to the right, but that would have been no good. But since you're holding turbo, you have no control. So that cut to the right would have been kind of slow. And by the time you did that, somebody else would have came off their block. Lawrence would have came and tackled you before you even made it 3 yards up the field. This tip is very important. And also another tip too is to always protect the ball. Because I guess the Madden developers beefed up the hit sticks and now they're more deadly. So I'm going to show you another example of holding turbo before too early, and it's not good. That was actually me holding turbo the whole time, and you might get one or two plays the whole game like that where you get lucky and hold turbo when your man actually blocked the people and you find the right hole. I mean, that hole wasn't too hard to miss, so you just gotta keep your eyes open down the field and always run up the field, not along the field like I'm doing here. That's the quickest way to pick up yards, not east and west, north and south. But here's another clip of smashing turbo. Even if I wanted to cut holding turbo, I would have been too slow to do anything. Another one. I mean, I picked up, 4 or 5 yards? But you're just killing your man's energy. There's another one holding turbo. I just don't think it's a most effective way of running the ball, because you have no control and you want to do moves. As you can see, as soon as I get the ball, I hit turbo. Man's already off his block. The linebacker's coming through the A gap and there's another defender in the biggest hole, so not really getting too far unless I make some type of move. But like I said, you have to be patient. Let your blockers do their job. So what's the point of having them if you're not gonna let them do their job? As you saw at the end of that play, Saquon, he gets mad at the end of this play. Cause he's like, come on bro, stop holding turbo. What you doing? And yeah man, this is real. When you're running too fast, you have no control. Driving too fast, you have no control. Honestly, I probably There was no way I was going to make it or gain any yards. You have the cornerback coming off his block. The linebacker is not even getting blocked. And there's no way I would have made any yards. Even if I tried to cut it back to the right, there's no way. And the best thing you can do here is just protect the ball, because they're bringing the hit sticks this year. It's way more effective. Seen a lot more fumbles. So this is where it begins, the tip, not holding the turbo. You see how much yards I gain by just letting my players, my linemen do their job, my tight end do their job. I get the handoff, and you can see everyone's blocked. Everyone's blocked. And there's better gaps. I have more control to run, to pick the hole I want to run to. There is a certain point I think you should use the acceleration burst, as in burst, not all the time. As soon as you get open field or see open field, hit turbo right away. I truck the smallest. Always try to truck the smallest people. Always. If your running back's bigger than them or has power, truck them. Only if they have power. I mean, you might get an animation when you get lucky and you can run over somebody bigger than your running back, but most likely you're going to fumble because the bigger guys are enforcers and they can lay the hit stick on you. But yeah, man, this is on all Madden. It's the same play. Single back ace, HB blunt dive. Not holding turbo again. I'm holding turbo as soon as I find the gap. And you see I get 5 yards. I know y'all saw that juke move. I mean, Saquon Barkley is amazing. Young running back. If I was holding turbo, I would have got tackled in the backfield. No lie. No cap. Right in the backfield. But since I'm not holding turbo, I have control. I'm able to see the field. And I make the juke move. And I'm able to pick up, 4 or 5 yards from that run. And I juke the cornerback. If the linebacker wasn't there, I would have picked up more yards. And they stopped me. Yeah, man, I'm telling you, this tip works, guys. It works. Just be patient. I probably could have cut it back to the right, but I wasn't really paying attention. Here is the same play. Just read the defense to make sure there's not 8 men in the box to the side you're running. And you'll be able to run to the strongest side where you think you have more blockers, and just let the play develop. And you see, there's a linebacker coming off the block. Since I'm not holding turbo again, I'm able to make the right cut to an open gap, and I'm able to run to the right up the middle, and pick up more yards, because I would have got tackled in the backfield, especially with the reaching tackles now. They can reach off the blocks and tackle you. And since that linebacker got engaged, I was able to run right behind him, pick up more yards, did a little juke move, covered the ball as soon as I did the juke move, just in case, and I pick up 8-10 yards on that play. So here's another one. Not holding turbo again. I think in this clip you can actually see when I started to hold turbo. Get the ball. Read the defense. Right to the right up the gap. That defense lineman, he's too late. I'm gonna make it before he makes it. And as soon as I get past my right left guard, that's when I hit turbo, right there. and I tried to chuck the safety, but I flopped. Manning. I wanted to bring you guys some game examples also. So, running with the same team, let the Cowboys score. Because all Madden, and I'm not just running the ball until I get turnover downs or score. And same base play I was picking in practice.
Here's the former number
That's
two
me
pick,
holding
the
turnover. And I get crushed right behind. They'll gain no yards just holding the turbo. And as you can see, every blocker is already running up the field for the next man to hit. And how is that going to help me as far as running the ball if they're not blocking the people in front of me? And like I said, since you have no control when you're running full speed, there's no way I can stop on a dime and cut it up the field to the right.
In on the tackle. Second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Running the ball is one of my favorite things to do.
Officially nothing on that last
play,
run. They'll try again second and 10.
I'm not holding a turbo at this point in this clip yet. As soon as I find a space or any type of space, that's when I'm going to turbo. I read the line and you can see the burst.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, and you know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game.
So what do you do? Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels. Because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage,
you can always tell when someone hits turbo. They just get the sudden burst of speed and I'm telling you, you have way more control.
And how about this one now? In their own territory,
zone,
gutsy
inside
call.
Zone to
they're going to go for this
touchdown.
On fourth and a yard.
Not holding turbo again. Let my players do their thing. Break a tackle. That's what I was talking about as far as depending on the running back. You can turbo.
A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. I love those plays. Fourth
as you can
and
see,
one. That's
also,
who wants it more this time, the offense.
Yeah, there's a lot of hooting and hollering in there,
right? A lot of contact and a lot of collisions as they try and find
just
some space. Who's going to drop their hips, gain leverage, and move the other side
that's
backwards? We saw it there
video,
for the offense getting it done.
Offensive line is blocked.
Drive so far. It's first and 10.
Cybermen, back up.
A first carry for the Clemson man, Wayne Gallman.
Not only terrible, but Jalen
Smith, who took a huge step forward last year, in on the tackle for Dallas.
Unrealistic.
We just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big. Manning turns and gives this to Gallman. He's got a first down and more inside the 30.
That's probably the biggest game I had with this guy.
That one good for 26 and a first down. Boy, the offensive line there, that was
exactly
a thing of beauty to
not
watch them block.
I love how you give a little appreciation for those big guys up front
no
and well-deserved. But how about the execution behind them? You can see the hours of practice that have gone into it. Great pocket by the running back.
Try
quarterback
it again.
Puts it right in the perfect spot. Great mesh point
Gelman.
By...
But let's go back to the replay. So, take the handoff. Read the offense lineman what they're doing, and I find a small little crease in the blocks, and that's when I hit turbo right there. Cut up the field with the little juke move. The computer did that, I didn't. But that's what happens when you run into the back of your own player. Madden just lets you put you in animation to diligent move.
On point, the run even better.
Try it one more time.
Here's Gallman.
I tried to
keep. And he'll take this one down near the 15.
Saw a gap to the left.
Credited with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Bring in Saquon back to finish off the drive here.
Defense hold him to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Turbo, because toss plays that you need your man.
On second down, here's Barkley.
I was hoping 70 picked up that block, but if he didn't. And I just ran right past him, so he missed the block, as you can see. Totally, he could have at least dove out there or something. It didn't have been one-on-one with the safety at the top of the screen, but he gets in my way. That's when I turn up the field, and that's when I hit turbo, and I run to the open space. 70 gets in my way because he's still not running full speed. He just like stops right here. Please like, share, subscribe also, and I will be bringing more content.